हाय एवरीबॉडी, वेरी गुड इवनिंग. दिस इज ईश्वर निगम और आपके सामने फिर से आज आया हूँ. लास्ट सैटरडे आई वाज विद ऑल ऑफ यू, इन फ्रंट ऑफ ऑल ऑफ यू, विद माय मेंटर, माय गुरु मिस्टर सोनू निगम. मैम, थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर गिविंग सो मच लव. थैंक यू एवरीबॉडी हु विश्ड मी ऑन माय बर्थडे. मैं सबको इंडिविजुअली रिस्पॉन्ड नहीं कर पाया, तो आपको सब बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया. टुडे इज अ ब्यूटिफुल डे बिकॉज आज मैं हूँ आपके बीच और टुडे इज अ वेरी स्पेशल गेस्ट हु वुड बी जॉइनिंग अस. शी इज आई डोंट थिंक उनको किसी भी इंट्रोडक्शन की ज़रूरत है. कुछ लोग ऐसे होते हैं जो अपनी लाइफ में एक ऐसे मकाम पे पहुंच जाते हैं जहां पर उनको इंट्रोडक्शन की ज़रूरत नहीं पड़ती है. फिर भी जो क्या कहते हैं, जो होस्ट होते हैं, टेक्निकली आज मैं होस्ट हूँ, तो वो उनके बारे में कुछ ना कुछ बताते ही हैं. तो उनके बारे में यही कहूँगा कि शी इज़ वन ऑफ द मोस्ट ब्यूटिफुल लेडीज़ ऑन दिस प्लानट, आई गेस अकॉर्डिंग टू मी. शी इज़ मॉडल, शी इज़ अ मार्वलस एक्ट्रेस, बॉलीवुड एक्ट्रेस, शी इज़ अ प्रोड्यूसर, शी इज़ अ सोशल वर्कर. And she is Miss Asia Pacific 2020. She is Dada Saheb Phalke Award winner, and she is Goodwill Ambassador at UN. And she has done a lot of work for our humanity, for our society, for our planet, for this nation. And she is always a smiling face. She is a beauty, and she is a boon for humankind. अगर हम आज ऐसे बात करें तो. Why Diya Mirza? ये मेरा कोई शो नहीं है, ये मेरा कोई सीरीज नहीं है. मैं बहुत कैजुअल हूँ अकॉर्डिंग टू माई, ओह सॉरी, आई सेड एशिया पैसिफिक 2000, एशिया पैसिफिक 2000, आई सेड 2020 का प्रकोप ऐसा है कि 2020 सुनाई देता है. सो जितने भी लोग जुड़ रहे हैं उन सबका बहुत बहुत स्वागत है. थैंक यू वेरी मच एवरीबॉडी. ये शाम फिर से खूबसूरत होगी एंड मोर देन ब्यूटीफुल. आई थिंक इट इज़ गोइंग टू बी अ मीनिंगफुल इवनिंग फॉर मी, फॉर ऑल ऑफ यू, क्योंकि हमारे साथ जुड़ने वाली हैं हम सबकी चहेती, हम सबकी प्यारी दिया मिर्ज़ा. सो आई वॉज सेइंग व्हाई दिया मिर्ज़ा. दिया मिर्ज़ा बिकॉज उनका एसोसिएशन रहा है मेरे साथ. यू नो, when I was in Saregamapa in 2006, she came there as a special, you know, guest. She came there to promote her movie. उस वक्त उनकी एक फिल्म आ रही थी अलग, बहुत बहुत अलग थी वो मूवी. I really liked the script and everything about the music, especially the music. She came there and you know, I was there, I was singing as a contestant, and उन्होंने मेरे परफॉर्मेंस के बाद मुझे वो कहा था जो एक्चुअली मुझे कहना चाहिए था, बट उन्होंने कहा था कि आपकी स्माइल ने तो मुझे मार ही डाला. सो दैट वाज 2006 एंड देन 2014 आई गेस, या 2014 शी वाज प्रोड्यूसिंग हर सेकंड मूवी बॉबी जासूस, एंड शी कॉल्ड मी अप फॉर अ ब्यूटीफुल सॉन्ग इन हर ब्यूटीफुल मूवी स्वीटी. एंड दैट वाज द सेकंड टाइम वी गॉट इन टच. And it was one of the most beautiful and one of the most peaceful, you know, experiences of my life while recording a song for a movie. Trust me, she was more than compassionate, you know, as an artist, I'm telling you. And उसके बाद आज का दिन है जब आज हम virtually मिलेंगे इस corona era में. तो इस वजह से, and I thought, you know, for me, she is one of the most sensible, one of the most genuine, and one of the most honest artists we have in India. And I'm glad that you know we know each other. So I thought, let me ask her, and she said yes, and I felt happy. And बहुत जल्दी, I guess she would be joining me. मैं ये Instagram live के साथ बहुत नया हूँ, तो मुझे बड़ा you know एक घबराहट रहती है कि जो मेरे गेस्ट हैं वो रिक्वेस्ट मुझे भेज दें और मुझे दिखाई ना दे. तो मैं आप लोगों के मैसेज भी पढ़ता रहूँगा. थैंक यू एवरीबॉडी फॉर जॉइनिंग मी. गेस्ट आने के पहले थोड़ा बहुत बात कर लेता हूँ, क्योंकि उसके बाद मैं चुप रहना ज़्यादा प्रेफर करूँगा, बिकॉज आई हैव लॉट ऑफ क्वेश्चंस फॉर दिया एज वेल. Finally, yes, my one of the most one of the most brightest faces you would ever see is with us. Please.
Yeah, let's go.
Hi.
Namaskar, Diya.
Namaste. How are you?
I'm doing fantastic. How are you doing?
I'm good. I'm seeing you after years.
I know, after 2014.
Yeah. It's been a long time.
So good to see your smile. Thank you very much for making our evening. You're most welcome. It's my pleasure. I was talking to all of my, you know, friends and all of your friends who have joined. कि मैं उनको बता रहा था, आर एसोसिएशन, इफ यू डोंट रिमेम्बर, यू केम टू सारेगामापा इन 2006. आई डोंट नो इफ यू रिमेम्बर. अच्छा, यू रिमेम्बर,
यू रिमेम्बर. एंड याद है, इनफैक्ट आपको वहां पे गाते हुए सुना था, और वो ऑब्वियसली इतना इंपैक्ट हुआ था उसका कि व्हेन वी वर कास्टिंग सिंगर्स फॉर आवर फिल्म, योर नेम केम टू माइंड. एंड I'm so glad कि हम collaborate कर पाए और आपने इतना खूबसूरत गाना गाया हमारे लिए.
Thank you very much. Absolutely my pleasure. So I was मेरी आवाज आ रही है?
जी बिल्कुल.
So we first met in 2006 and then for your second movie as a producer, Bobby Jasus. I loved the movie and I loved the song. And उसके बाद हम आज मिल रहे हैं. So in my experience, ये 14 साल बीत गए, but today when I look at you, you don't look even a day older. When will you start aging, Diya? That's my first question.
You know, honestly, Aishwarya, I think क्योंकि मेरी मैंने करियर इतने कम उम्र में स्टार्ट किया था. मैं 19 साल की थी जब मेरी पहली फिल्म आई, तो शायद लोगों को लगता हो मेरी उम्र बहुत ज्यादा हो गई है, लेकिन मैं ऑफ कोर्स आई एम नॉट इन माय 20s एनी मोर, आई एम माय लेट 30s. लेकिन कम उम्र शायद, पता नहीं, बहुत लोग ये कहते हैं और मुझे हमेशा, मैं बहुत चौंक जाती हूँ जब ये सवाल करते हैं, क्योंकि मुझे समझ नहीं आता है मैं क्या कहूँ. आई गेस आई एम जस्ट लकी एंड ब्लेस्ड कि मेरा डीएनए शायद ठीक है, और फिर ऑब्वियसली अपना ख्याल रखती हूँ मैं. 17-18 सालों से मेडिटेशन कर रही हूँ, रोज एक्सरसाइज करती हूँ, जो खाती हूँ उसका बहुत, मतलब परहेज नहीं कह सकते, बट आई ट्राई एंड ईट हेल्दी, आई ट्राई एंड ईट माइंडफुली. बट आई थिंक सबसे बड़ी बात, इंसान की खूबसूरती तभी नजर आती है जब आप अपना दिल खुश रखते हैं, और दिल में कभी कोई रिजेंटमेंट या बिटरनेस नहीं पालते. आई थिंक दैट्स द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट थिंग. जब आप अंदर से खुश होते हो तो वो चेहरे पर झलकता है.
आई थिंक दैट वुड बी द परफेक्ट आंसर फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन. वेरी ट्रू, सुपर, वाह. एंड सो मेरा जो अगला सवाल है वो इसी सवाल से जुड़ा है. We all know the privileges of being beautiful, you know, in this patriarchal society, in this country. I want to know, what are the challenges of being beautiful here?
I think patriarchy, and also the fact that we have so little respect for women. Although हमारी संस्कृति, हमारी सभ्यता यही सिखाती है कि औरतों की मर्यादा करनी चाहिए, उनकी रिस्पेक्ट करनी चाहिए, आई थिंक वी फेल टू रियली अंडरस्टैंड दैट. सो इट स्टार्ट्स ऑफ फॉर मी, आई थिंक इट वुड बी द मोस्ट डिसरिस्पेक्टफुल थिंग टू मी इज ऑब्जेक्टिफिकेशन ऑफ अ वुमन, व्यूइंग अ वुमन एज अ not as a thinking feeling person but as an object of desire. And I think as an actor also, when you talk about what has been my biggest challenge being beautiful, I think it's been to find a place for myself that is not purely one that associates me with the way I look, but for the work that I do, for the person that I am. And
absolutely.
I mean, you can be blessed with good looks, but that can't define everything that you are.
Mm-hmm.
And I think the other challenge is that hamesha har mode ke zindagi ke har mode pe conditions aa jati hain jab aap ladki hote hain to ye jab ek matlab kis tarah ka kaam karna chahiye kya wo safe hai ya nahi घर से कितने बजे निकलना चाहिए, घर तक घर वापस कितने बजे आना चाहिए, किस तरह के कपड़े पहनने चाहिए, किस तरह से बोलना चाहिए, किस तरह से उठना चाहिए, किस तरह से बैठना चाहिए.
I know.
उसके बाद इट्स एम्बिशन कितना होना चाहिए
वो भी उसके भी लिमिटेशंस है.
हाँ, शादी कब होगी, बच्चे कब होंगे, मतलब एवरीथिंग दैट यू आर एज अ वुमन इज कॉन्स्टेंटली questioned, and people have an opinion about everything. So I think women can have it very tough in a patriarchal society, and we continue to find our balance and find our way, and despite it all.
I know, and it is really, really tough, you know. ये सुनकर भी, क्योंकि ऐसा लगता है, it feels very hopeless or sometimes helpless, you know. क्योंकि मैं I have seen my sisters growing up in a society like this, and in fact I just got married, and whenever me and my wife,
you know,
thank you we are out on roads, तो ये बहुत झेलने को मिलता है.
Yeah.
It's sad, but glad that we have women like you who are setting example in a country like this. Okay,
yeah,
so
I think as women we have to keep reminding ourselves ki other people's opinions and views of us can't define us. We have to define our own,
absolutely,
choices in our lives, and do it with respect and regard and love for everyone around you and the people that you work with. But it has to start from just understanding yourself first. Wo jo personal identity banni chahiye, I think for men and for women, it's equally important. You can't be defined by the work that you do. You can't be defined by the way you look. You can't be defined by who you're married to. Everything that you are has to originate from within. And you need to understand that first.
Beautiful.
किसी ने पूछा जब मैं जवाब दे रही थी कि मैं किस तरह का मेडिटेशन करती हूँ.
अच्छा, ओके.
तो I started off with doing the Sudarshan Kriya. I still do it. I did the Art of Living course, and then of course after I did the beginner's course, I did the advanced courses as well. I've also done the Vipassana. But now I've kind of found my own rhythm of meditation. But what I do is I make sure that the first 2 hours of my day are entirely for myself. तो इवन अगर मुझे शूट के लिए भी, अगर शूट के तैयार होने के लिए 7 बजे लोकेशन पर पहुंचना पड़े और 1 घंटे की दूरी हो या 1.5 घंटे की दूरी हो, तो मैं 3.5 घंटे पहले उठ के आई स्टार्ट माय होल रूटीन ऑफ योगा एंड मेडिटेशन एंड स्पेंडिंग टाइम विद माय सेल्फ एंड देन गेट रेडी एंड गो टू वर्क. आई थिंक दैट्स वेरी नेसेसरी टू स्टार्ट योर डे विद योर सेल्फ, यू नो, विद नो डिस्ट्रैक्शंस, विद नथिंग एल्स. Of course, अगर आपके दूसरे commitments हैं, तो then you have to wake up even earlier. But it's made a big difference.
You know, Dia, I'm so glad that I'm, you know, doing this session. Trust me, these sessions has no other intentions other than the fact that because जब हम मुंबई आए थे, so हमारे लिए ये सारे actors, actresses, singers and all celebrities ये हमारे लिए examples होते थे. And through these sessions, when you say कि आपका जब शेड्यूल होता है, आप 3 घंटे पहले उठकर अपना मेडिटेशन करती हैं, जो फॉलोवर्स हैं, जो आपके या जो मेरे फ्रेंड्स हैं, ये इंटरव्यू जब दोबारा कोई भी सुनेगा, बहुत कुछ सीखने को मिलता है कि ये चकाचौंध के ये जो चेहरे हैं, ये सच में अपने लिए जीते हैं पहले, ये इनका सिर्फ प्रोफेशन है. दे आर नॉट कंप्लीटली यू नो डिफाइंड बाय देयर प्रोफेशन. दे आर अ ह्यूमन बीइंग एंड दिस इज जस्ट अ पार्ट ऑफ देयर लाइफ. थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर यू नो मेंशनिंग दिस. मेरा अगला सवाल है आपसे. आपके जिंदगी के दो फेजेस हैं जितना हमें बाहर से दिखता है. एक व्हेन यू वर यू नो डूइंग द मेन स्ट्रीम बॉलीवुड सिनेमा एंड टुडे व्हेन यू आर इन्वॉल्व्ड ह्यूजली इन्वॉल्व्ड विद सच प्रोफाउंड एक्टिविटीज ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड. यू नो यू आर यू एन गुडविल एम्बेसडर एंड यू आर डूइंग सो मेनी वर्क. यू आर इन्वॉल्व विद वन ऑफ माई फ्रेंड्स ऑर्गेनाइजेशन मिशन ग्रीन मुंबई एंड आई एम सो हैप्पी. आई जस्ट वॉन्टेड टू नो वॉट एग्जैक्टली हैपेंड. What was the moment when you decided that you should, you know, put your life into this? You should make this happen. You should fix this issue. What happened to you?
I think it happened gradually, but it starts with knowing that there is no greater sense of well-being than a life that is lived in service, seva. Uh-huh. आई थिंक जितना सेवा से सुख मिलता है किसी और चीज से नहीं मिलता. और हम कलाकार हैं, आर्टिस्ट हैं, हमारी जो लेवल्स ऑफ एम्पैथी है वो हाइटेंड होती हैं. हम लोगों का दुख समझते हैं, उनका सुख समझते हैं. और आई थिंक जब हम पर्यावरण की बात करते हैं तो हमारी जिंदगी से हर वो जुड़ी चीज़ जिसकी हमें ज़रूरत है, सांस लेने के लिए हवा, स्वच्छ हवा, पीने के लिए पानी, खाने के लिए खाना, ये सब हमें प्रकृति से ही तो मिलता है. और जिस तरह से हम जीने लगे हैं, यू नो लिविंग कम्प्लीटली कंज्यूमरिस्ट लाइव्स, नॉट रिस्पेक्टिंग नेचर एंड एनवायरनमेंट, नॉट अंडरस्टैंडिंग आवर कनेक्शन विद नेचर, हैज लेड टू अ लॉट ऑफ डिस्ट्रक्शन. एंड द मोर आई डिस्कवर्ड अबाउट हाउ बैड द सिचुएशन इज, द मोर इट strengthened my resolve to be a part of the solution. क्योंकि बुरी खबर पढ़ने से अच्छा है कि अच्छे काम में जुड़ जाओ. जो बुरी खबर है उससे उसे पढ़ के, सुन के, देख कर जो दुख होता है वो थोड़ा दुख कम हो जाता है. तो आई काइंड ऑफ कीप माई सेल्फ एंगेज एंड इन्वॉल्व इन थिंग्स दैट गिव मी strength and motivate me, and I think in many ways I've just defined my purpose in life. My purpose is communication, the arts, creativity. I really feel the films, storytelling, photography are very powerful instruments of social change.
Absolutely.
And as artists, if we can use the sphere of our influence to first learn ourselves and then share that knowledge with more people, I guess it just makes our lives richer.
Beautiful. Very nice. Very clear. Okay.
Are you taking people's questions also?
No. Because मेरे पास बहुत सारे questions हैं आपसे पूछने के लिए. And I don't want to distract myself, you know, with the comments. I know. Sure. So my next question to you is, this is my question since very long I wanted to ask. I thought, let me ask you because you're the very right person. You know, even you are involved in so many activities which is happening right now for the environment and for the planet itself. I wanted to know, the current scenario is, as a species, it's we who are in danger, not the planet. Because studies show that if tomorrow, if all of us disappear, human species, the planet would flourish.
Really well without us.
Yeah. So why always the campaign which is happening around the globe, why it is always tweaked around, let's save the planet? Why it's not saying, let's save us? Why is it happening? And why do you think, where is this coming from?
Well, you're very right, Aishwarya. And I think more and more people have started acknowledging that. Maybe we are the virus. Given how destructive we are as a species. Uh-huh. मैं हमेशा बच्चों से जब बात करती हूँ हमेशा उनसे यही कहती हूँ कि क्या आप किसी और स्पीसीज को जानते हैं जो कचरा पैदा करता हो.
Right.
We're the only species from the natural world that has removed ourselves from the natural world, separated ourselves from nature, and has built cities, towns, and societies, and the world that is so removed from nature and away from nature. And I think that has also given us a false sense of who we are. It's also made us very arrogant. हमको ऐसे लगता है कि we control everything.
Yeah.
But I think if there is one big example in our lifetime that has taught us that we don't control anything, that nature is not above us, nature is not, we are not above nature, sorry, is this pandemic.
Yeah, absolutely.
It is our broken relationship with nature. It is our destruction of nature. It is our wrongful interactions and usage of, you know, wildlife, the way we trade wildlife, the way we are treating wild animals that has led us here and has caused in like this extraordinary human crisis. आप कभी सोच सकते थे कि within your lifetime सारे airports बंद हो जाएंगे, सारे शहर बंद हो जाएंगे, trains बंद हो जाएंगी, transport बंद हो जाएगा. हमने तो कभी नहीं सोचा था. तो I think, और ये scientists हमें कह रहे हैं पिछले 100 साल से 80 साल से हम बार बार ये कहते हुए आ रहे हैं कि हम जिस तरह खा रहे हैं, जिस तरह मास प्रोडक्शन कर रहे हैं, हर चीज का जो हमने इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन कर दिया है, द वे वी आर डिसरिस्पेक्टिंग नेचर इज गोइंग टू कॉज सीरियस डैमेज. एंड यस, इट इज कॉजिंग डिस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ नेचुरल एनवायरनमेंट्स. वी आर लूजिंग स्पीसीज रैपिडली एवरी डे, बट अलोंग विद दैट वी आर ऑल्सो लूजिंग वॉट इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बैलेंस, जो संतुलन है प्रकृति का, वो उसको हमने नष्ट किया है, उसको खराब कर रहे हैं. एंड दैट अफेक्ट्स अस, इट अफेक्ट्स यू एंड मी, आवर चिल्ड्रन, एंड नॉट इन द फ्यूचर, इट्स हैपनिंग राइट नाउ इन द प्रेजेंट मोमेंट. सो एक बहुत पुराना नेटिव अमेरिकन फ्रेज है, वी डू नॉट, वी बोरो द फ्यूचर फ्रॉम आवर चिल्ड्रन. So how much, but we are not borrowing anymore, we are stealing. We're stealing from our children, and we need to recognize that. We need to understand ki gadbad hai, is tarah jeene mein bahut bahut gadbad hai.
And so do you also feel that the campaign should be, you know, they should say that let's save ourselves, it's not the planet who is in danger, it's us who is in danger? Or do you think this would work more?
Humans are a very complex species, Aishwarya. I mean, even now with, you know, climate change is so evident, you know, it's so obvious. Glaciers are melting rapidly, forest fires are happening in quick succession and more intensity than ever before. There's so much flooding happening, the intensity and frequency of flooding has increased, but still there are so many people who don't recognize that climate is changing, that it is human behavior and our activities that is causing climate change. So there is a level of denial in everyone. Now, if you start saying that save ourselves, everybody will be like, but I'm fine, I'm comfortable, I'm at home, and I have food to eat. And people will not understand. I think communication will evolve and has been. I feel activists, especially young activists in our country and around the world, especially Greta Thunberg, started the Fridays for Future movement. She says it like it is. वो नहीं कहती कि save the planet. She says we need to, our house is burning. We've caused the fire. We have to douse the fire because our lives are at risk. So I think that's a very powerful thought, and a lot many more people are understanding that now more than ever before. मुझे ऐसे लगता है कि और बहुत सारे ऐसे लोग हैं जो ये बात समझ पा रहे हैं अभी.
Glad that I got to ask this question to somebody who's, you know, you have the answer. My next question to you is, aapke bachpan mein chalte hain, if you allow me to. What is the first conscious memory you have of your own self?
being bathed in a pink bathtub with blue and white beads. And my mother still can't believe I have this memory and that I remember this. Kyunki, aur fir wo meko tel malish karti thi, mujhe wo bhi yaad hai. I can almost see her with her eyes twinkling, smiling at me and massaging me. And so jab main 7-8-9 saal ki thi, main mom ko kehti thi, mujhe pata hai, aapko pata hai, mujhe abhi bhi apna bathtub yaad hai. To wo kehti thi, chal jhooti. And I would be like, pink color ka tha, baby pink color ka tha, uske white aur blue color ki beads the side mein, aur wo main beads ke
saath. My goodness.
And she would be like, how do you remember? Wo tub, kyunki unhone obviously when I was like less than a year old, had she had given it away to somebody else who'd had a child. And she still cannot believe how I remember this.
And how old were you? Around?
Must have been a few months. I mean, like, she bathed me in that from the day I was brought home till I was about a year old.
Okay. Maybe 6 months?
Must have been. I don't know.
My goodness. You had that memory. It's amazing, huh?
Yeah.
Okay. So tell me one thing. If that baby Diya, if that 6 months old baby Diya comes right in front of you, then nobody else is there other than you two. What would be the conversation be like? Is it something which you would want to talk to her, say her?
I would. Wow, what a lovely question.
And is there something which the baby Diya wants to tell the current Diya Mirza?
I think the baby will want to tell me, don't worry, it'll all be okay. And I would say to the baby, hey, I didn't do too badly, did I?
Okay. Lovely. Good. Wow. Mera agla sawal hai. Again, this is my kafi samay se I had this question. Jo ye gender equality chal raha hai, jo abhi filhal. Mujhe, this is what I feel, and I have experienced this also. Is gender equality ke aad mein, iske chakkar mein, most of the females, most of the ladies, most of the women, you know, they in just trying to prove that they are, you know, standing, head to head, standing in the same space, they are losing their femininity. I think they are becoming, they are becoming men-like. It's not that, they are becoming men-like. When I say men-like, they are losing the quality of feminine. And when I say that, this is what I have experienced. They are losing it. But, you know, I have a very beautiful example. You know, Sadhguru says, you know, a pure feminine should be extremely powerful, extremely fierce, but very intact, very, you know, the innocence, the feminine quality is very intact in it. And I have a beautiful example, sitting right in front of me. You are extremely powerful when it comes to, you know, putting your words through. You are extremely fierceful, right? You know, doing right things in the world. But your innocence and you are the most feminine female I have ever seen. So if you don't think that I'm asking the right question, you can skip this question. But this is what I feel. Most women are losing the female quality. Just to prove that, you know, we are standing.
I feel like you're a musician. You should understand this. You're somebody who's got such a beautiful gift. ये जो रस होते हैं ना भाव, ये सब में होते हैं. और ये आप पता है, आपको पता है कितने कितने तरह के भाव हैं. कितने भाव हैं ऐश्वर्या, बताओ.
कुछ 12 हैं, 12 या 14 हैं.
ठीक है.
कितने
14 ले लो. ठीक है,
14.
ये हर इंसान में होते हैं. कुछ भाव ज्यादा होते हैं, कुछ कम होते हैं. सो आई थिंक जो femininity and masculinity are an equal part of a man also.
Correct.
Men also have it. In some men, the femininity is higher, the masculinity is lower. In some women, the masculinity is higher, the femininity is lower. It doesn't make, it's not an imbalance. It is just, I feel in many ways, their survival, their means to survive. because we all have very different life experiences. Mm-hmm. And it's our life experiences that teach us how to respond to life and to people. So if mm-hmm. you're referring to aggression or I see that level of aggression even in men. And I question aggression in both in men and in women. Because, mm-hmm. you know, you don't need to be loud to be heard. Mm-hmm. You don't need to be rude to be mm-hmm. to get your point across. Mm-hmm. It, those are things that come from an innate respect for yourself mm-hmm. and for others. Now, mm-hmm. if these are, I think when we talk about feminism, it mm-hmm. is... it is about respecting all people equally. So, and when we talk about gender equality, it's about believing with all and complete understanding that you deserve an equal mm-hmm. right and an equal choice in life, in all spheres of life. Aap ladki ho to aap school nahi ja sakte hain. आप लड़की हो तो आप पे आपको पता है कि देयर इज एन इंबैलेंस देयर इज अ ह्यूज इंबैलेंस इन दिस वर्ल्ड एंड आई फील दैट समटाइम्स सम पीपल मे कम अक्रॉस एज अग्रेसिव बट दे डू इट मोस्टली बिकॉज देव गॉन थ्रू सर्टेन एक्सपीरियंसेस दैट हैव मेड देम लाइक दैट सो आई डोंट व्यू इट फ्रॉम द लेंस ऑफ gender equality or somebody mm-hmm. fighting for gender equality and doing so aggressively and that fight is what is making them aggressive. I don't think mm-hmm. that is the reason. Okay. I think aggression comes from experience or our inability to manage or balance our emotions. Mm-hmm. It has nothing to do with the cause.
Okay. Thank you. Good that I got that perspective too.
Yeah, that's what I feel. And it's also upbringing. If you're rude to people, mm-hmm. you're just a badly behaved
person. I agree.
It has nothing to do with your cause or what you're fighting for or what you believe uh-huh. in, you care mm-hmm. about. Mm-hmm.
Yes, very true. Dia, your most painful moment till today and most joyful moment till today, your experience and your learning from it.
So I feel like there is no greater pain than the loss of a loved one.
Absolutely.
That physical void is just, you learn to live with it. But yeah, it's the kind of pain that really, really affects you deeply. But also I think it propels a lot of growth. Because it makes you ask the right questions. It helps you value those who are in your life more. Mm-hmm. You know, I remember after my father passed away, it made me so much more mindful of the time that I have with my mother. Mm. You know, it just makes you more alive and present mm-hmm. towards those who are there in your life. And I think it's loss is, of course, it can be death. It can also be the failure of a relationship. That's equally painful. And it's like something inside. It's like something dying, right? It's very, very painful. But there are many, many lessons and many learnings even in that. And you just have to be, you know, willing to discover that, whatever it is, mm-hmm. the learning. Mm-hmm. Happiness, I feel the biggest. I haven't had a biggest high. I've had many highs, and I'm very grateful Beautiful. For them. Because I feel, unlike pain, joy can be experienced in to very many, many, many ways. You know,
totally agree. Totally agree.
And it can happen in the most unexpected times. And yes. They're not all joy is not always reward based. That's what I feel. कि वो अगर हम joy में एक reward का association कर दे तो फिर आप मैं कह सकती हूँ कि like I always say, you know, when people say how did you feel when you won the Miss Asia Pacific, mm-hmm. I said I felt like a winner the day I went back home and at the airport I could hug my mother and my father.
Wow.
You know, it was that connection, that moment, mm-hmm. that completed the real moment for me. You know? Mm-hmm. So I feel happiness is something you can experience every day. There are extraordinary highs you can experience. Like my biggest highs have been when I've been in nature, or I've been around loved ones, or I've experienced the joy of watching a film with my entire team for the first time, or, you know, writing something, or creating something, or just watching my nieces or my nephews doing something for the first time, or watching them doing it joyfully. So I think highs, big highs are like, they keep changing in form and hue and this thing. So,
perfect answer. Perfect
for me,
answer.
Joy is not reward based at all.
Wow. ये तो मैं इसको ये बात तो लिखने वाली बात है. Joy is not a reward based. Wow. Very beautiful. And इस session को ज्यादा आगे ना बढ़ाते हुए आई वुड आस्क माई लास्ट क्वेश्चन. दो वी डोंट विश दिस, बट इफ दिस वॉज योर लास्ट डे, व्हाट वुड यू डू, व्हाट वुड यू लाइक टू डू एंड गो?
सो महात्मा गांधी हैड सेड, लिव ईच डे लाइक इट वर योर लास्ट. एंड माय फादर यूज्ड टू से दिस अ लॉट, माय मदर हैज ऑलवेज सेड इट टू मी. And I feel like I try and live every day like it's my last. Because as long as I'm not hurting somebody,
mm-hmm.
and I'm peaceful and I'm happy and I'm doing what gives me joy, and I think that's good enough. There's nothing else to be done.
Beautiful. Thank you very much, Dia Mirza, for you know, giving me this opportunity that I can ask.
I'm not going to let you go without singing a song.
No, I'm not singing. Ye to mera, you know, this is
my... I've earned it. I answered all your questions.
Achha.
Please, ek gana gado.
Which song? Tell me.
Sweetie, yaad hai?
Of course, yaad hai.
Yeah.
सच गई देखो मेरे आनंद नान की, कुर्ती रेशम शरारे सोला हो सिंगार की, नैना काजल वाले जादू वादू डाले, लूट ले सारा ये समार. स्वीटी डोंट यू सी आई एम डांसिंग फॉर दी, स्वीटी डोंट यू सी आई एम डांसिंग फॉर दी. Thank you once again, and I had one of the most beautiful times while recording a song. You know, I just wanted to say this. Main tab keh nahi paya.
Hum dance kar rahe the. Kitna maza aaya.
Uff. Hum dance kar rahe the. Hum. I just wanted to say this. Let me say this, dear. You know, I have done a lot of songs for a lot of people, for a lot of movie, for a lot of composers. You called me up for a song, you know, for Bobby Jasus, and. Till the time, you know, everything, I mean, I was there for the shoot of the song also. And we came back for the screening, and then I got a letter from, you know, Bonfire, from
Bonfree.
Yep. And the experience which I had, this is very important as a singer also, I'm telling, this is the experience which I had is so compassionate. I never felt that I'm, you know, doing something and this is my profession. Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. Thank you very much for treating me with a motherly compassion. Thank you very much, dear. You are a beautiful lady. You are amazing. And my truest prayer and love for you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
It starts, everything starts and ends with respect.
Thank you for joining me. Thank you.
I hope we can work together again. And I really
appreciate. Absolutely.
Thank you for having me. It was such a pleasure. And thank you to everyone who joined us. Lots of love to everyone. Bye.
Goodbye.